Hello everyone, in this video we'll talk about BGP protocol, that is Border Gateway Protocol. And this protocol is external to the network, that is all two autonomous systems, they communicate through each other through the BGP protocol. So BGP protocol, it is a inter-domain routing protocol, whereas RIP as well as OSPF, they are called as intra-domain routing protocol. Whereas BGP is inter-domain, that is, it helps in the communication between the autonomous systems. BGP provides each autonomous system a means to, one is eBGP. eBGP helps in the, it is called as external BGP, which helps in the communication between the neighbors autonomous system. Whereas iBGP, it helps to propagate the information within the autonomous system, that is in between the routers within a single autonomous system. That is why it is called as internal BGP, and eBGP is external BGP. It helps to communicate between the neighbors autonomous systems. Determine good routers to other networks based on reachability information and policy. So good routers determine good routers, and which helps in the shortest path and the reachability information, and based on the policy measures the protocol is going to work. It allows the subset to advertise its existence to rest of the internet. That is, I'm here message is being exchanged between the autonomous systems, so allow subnet to advertise its existence to the other routers in the network. BGP, it works on the basis of BGP sessions, and two BGP routers, they are going to communicate through BGP messages. First one is advertising paths to different destination networks, that is through the prefixes, through the path vector protocol, exchanged over semi-permanent TCP connection. We can see an example here. Then autonomous system 3 advertises the prefix to autonomous system 1. See here we have the autonomous system 3, and it wants to advertise its information to other autonomous systems in the network. So it is going to send the message to autonomous system 1. So it has broadcasted the message. So AS3 can aggregate the prefixes in its advertisements, and that the same message is sent to from AS3 to AS1 through the border routers. So 3A to 1C, the message is being advertised. Now as you can see here, IBGP, it is internal to that particular autonomous system, which is indicated with the dotted lines. And inter-autonomous system, that is a communication between the two different autonomous systems, it is done through eBGP, that is external border gateway protocol sessions. So using each BGP session between 3A and 1C, AS3 sends a prefix reachability to autonomous system 1. 1C can then use iBGP to distribute the same information among different routers within the autonomous system. Next we have 1B, which is have a connectivity with AS2. So 1B again is going to re-advertise the reachability information to AS2. So it's going to broadcast AS3 plus AS1 information to AS2, to 1B to 2A, and again it's going to use external BGP sessions. So when router learns of new prefixes, there's an entry for prefix in its routing table, and the same thing is forwarded further. So this is done through path attributes and BGP routers. Path attributes, we consider the prefix as well as the attributes, is equal to considered as the route. We already know the prefixes. What are the attributes? First one is AS path, that is autonomous system path, which contains the autonomous through which the prefixes are advertisements has been passed. That is, right now we have a session here. If AS1 receives the advertisement from AS3, when it is going to forward, it's going to add the path. That is AS2, it receives the advertisements of AS1 as well as AS3. So this is considered as the prefix advertisement has been passed. Example, AS3 and AS2. For example, we are considered if it AS17 has received the information from AS67. And these two together, it will be passed further. Next, we have the next hop. It indicates the specific internal autonomous system router to next hop autonomous system. That is, it's going to inform this internal autonomous system routers information to the next autonomous system. It may have the multiple links to a single autonomous system. If you have the autonomous system, can have the multiple links. All the information is being exchanged internal to the autonomous system as well as to the external. Rootway, gateway routers receiving the root advertisement, it uses the import policy to accept or decline the advertisements from the neighboring nodes. Example, router routes through the autonomous system. It can route through the autonomous system or it may not route. So, never route through that particular autonomous system. So, everything works on the basis of policy-based routing. So, how the GP is going to select a path? There are four different methods. First one is local preference value attribute is given, or shortest path, that is to the attribute AS path. Next, hop which is closest to the router, that method is called as hot potato routing, or some additional criteria is also considered. Some of the BGP messages that are exchanged between the peers are, first one is open, it opens the TCP connection between the peers, so that authentication message is being sent between the sender and receiver. Next we have the update, it's going to advertise a new path into the neighbors, that is update the information which was already stored within its routing information. Keep alive, it keeps the connection alive for certain amount of time. It also accepts the acknowledgements, that is acknowledgements are also accepted. Next we have the notifications, reports error in the previous message, and also it's going to close the connection. So these are the four messages that are being exchanged in the PGP protocol. Thank you.